Yeah.
Lil Tracy and Lil Peep. Nice to see you guys.
I said Tracy's most spooky than him.
In what way? What did you guys have album costumes or not?
He had a fucking full body chicken suit.
Really? So you're that kind of rapper who's not afraid to wear a chicken suit.
He's Lil Peep.
Oh fuck, now I get it. Okay.
Yeah. I have no fear in my heart.
You have no fear in your heart? That's really interesting. Also, shout out to my man Ned over here. Hey, and I'm sick, so instead of drinking like beer or cocaine or anything, I'm gonna drink this
drink.
Yo, you know you can do that. I think it just like, destroys your insides, right? I heard somebody talk about it one time.
I'll do drugs.
No?
Sober gay.
Sober gay. Tracy, it's nice to see you on the show finally. I've been aware for a long time through this guy Ned to my left, and finally we're fucking having a conversation on air. It's a beautiful thing.
Very rare moment.
Very, very rare. And it's Halloween! Can I just say that?
Right?
It's Halloween! That's crazy.
That's how you know it's real.
That's how you know it's true spooky hours, yeah.
Real spooky blunt.
Spooky as blunt. Can we talk about that spooky as blunt that you kind of became a meme for briefly online the last time you were on the podcast?
What blunt was that?
You had a blunt that sort of had like a curve, like a downward curve to it, and people were kind of trying to make fun of you for it, but I only saw a couple pictures of it. It didn't seem like going too hard, but.
Oh, I don't remember that.
I
don't know.
That one looks. I think it's because we're really carrying it around for a while.
Yeah, smoking on dead dicks.
Yeah, you know, that cat's spooky as fuck, too. If he shows up on the table, I'm gonna know that it's a true monster match. The graveyard status.
He's shedding,
bro. Right? Monster match? Are we been going, like, I don't know about you guys, but I've been going so fucking hard. It's Monday. I've been going so hard all weekend. I tried to go hard all weekend, but it just been caught up to me, and now it's Monday, and I can't.
I'm sleeping. I slept for 15 hours. I ate a whole extra large pizza a couple nights ago. That shit was crazy. I ate 12 slices of pizza.
12? Right in a row?
Yeah, 12 slices.
And
then
fat burger.
No, and then later that day I ordered double cheeseburger and fat burger. And I got
our
Comfort LA.
Comfort LA is my shit.
It's not that good. I'm speaking as the actual black person.
Yeah, Comfort LA is not that good.
But I see that shit on Uber Eats all the time. That's what I'm thinking of, right?
Mm-hmm.
Are you guys Uber Eats can?
I got free, yeah.
Oh, you give out the code?
I give out the code, bro. I got like thousands of dollars on that.
Same. Thank you very much.
Shout out Uber Eats.
Out there. We love you.
I haven't fucking... I went to the grocery store the whole time. I was in my house.
I didn't know.
I eat like 400 a day.
Yeah, but this is like society split right here. These two over here do not have the Uber Eats credit unlocked like you do on this side of the table. Sorry, guys. I don't want to make you get jealous or anything.
Fuck you. Yeah. Shots fired.
It would be so gutter if I fucking put the code, my code for this.
You should offload our
a contest.
I'm saying use that code right there.
It's mine first.
$10 off your first.
You heard me. You already got $1,000 on there. Use mine.
$1,000. Hey, Ned demanded that you be on this podcast because he said that he put you guys together. Don't you say industry guy?
Ha! Yes. I'm pretty sure I can introduce him.
I don't even remember me in Tracy. I've known Tracy yet, but like centuries. I know him from a past life. It's spiritual.
Because they brought us together, but why are we still hanging out?
Exactly. We probably brought a lot of people together, yeah.
Bring everybody together.
You just know, these are some heroes that I haven't spent too much time with. I don't know who, but I mean, shout out to the Jacob friends who did some meeting years. You're a weird ass. That was a long time ago, yeah. Sometimes you just sit your
house. That was a juicy day show.
Was that it? I remember we were sitting smoking a blunt in some parking lot by Fairfax. I remember it was like a guy's.
Oh, yeah. That's
the first time I met.
That was when I smoked the weed.
Okay, so tell me some. How did you meet these guys? Let's get some statistics.
I met him like 2 years ago, and I fucked with his music. And it was when I was in Brax House. And I was like, yo, I'm in Brax. And then he like moved from the VA to LA to my house to the lights. And that's how I met him. And I think Pete liked my music.
Fuck him up.
So
you're saying it basically transformed into the GothboiClique thing?
Kind of, like, all, most of the members, I think, were pretty much from there, except for, like, Doug.
Right.
And, like, JP Dream.
When did GothboiClique?
Yeah.
When did GothboiClique become a thing?
It was, like, 2 years ago, wasn't it?
Yeah.
It was, like, pretty
much. It was, like, and Call Hard.
It was, like, summer of 2014.
Right. And you guys, you take it pretty seriously, because I see you guys putting out songs on
that SoundCloud.
But the love right above it is that like when you got back in the GP.
Yeah,
Before we go any deeper on this, what is this? You have an insane I don't think anyone could see it besides me. I haven't heard you do it.
It
could have been worse if you got shot by a fucking rubber bullet by a police officer in the middle of the highway or something like that. That could have worked. So, but you guys all used to be roommates too, up until fairly recently.
We were like all caps everything together for like stuff.
But at that same place, the place I joined in, we did, you live at now?
No. In Pasadena.
Pasadena, so we did Rasta, then went to Whittier, and shit, got fucked up over there. Then went to Skid Row, you know what I'm saying? Still over there on Skid, you know.
So is Skid Row the only place that can handle you guys?
No.
I love you.
We're handled worldwide.
We're handled gang.
No, but honestly though, like, the OSS store is in kind of a sketchy area for anybody who's ever been over here, but the men's apartment is fucking ISIS and Canada.
No.
We're in the Skid.
They're friendly.
They're friendly, but they're also like Skid Row.
Yeah. I walked through, there were some girls the other day that I thought was dumb.
Tracy got hit with rice, though. I'm telling you, I just threw a whole box. I didn't even see it.
There's like a racist joke, but they fucked it up. It's like, no, but not Asian.
Why did they throw it at you?
African is like the only community on earth that doesn't eat rice. I love rice.
I hate rice.
I mean, like, traditional. Okay, but how did this happen?
I just turned the corner and
he said he was lying down.
Didn't you guys throw like flour out the window?
Yeah, they thought it was cut.
They threw flour. They were so mad.
They were mad. They started catching the coke and then
they were sniffing it.
They got mad because they sniffed it and it wasn't coke.
It was hard sugar.
That's like
funnel cake happens.
That says a lot about you guys that the homeless people assumed that you would be throwing coke.
We were throwing clothes out there and saying we were
trying to toss it. You guys ever throw coke out the window? You ever just get sick of it? You're like, I had enough of this shit. So,
never that.
Really? Wow.
I've thrown all types of drugs all over the world.
Oh, no, just skip that up.
Yeah. No.
Oh, just up. Everything
goes out the way.
If I'm lit enough, it's just gonna go in the air.
You might just decide that you had enough drugs for the night.
Remember that dude threw mollies at you, Lewis?
Huh?
When that dude threw mollies at you?
Yeah, dude, he got mad as fuck at me for no reason, and he was like, here, fuck you then, and threw mollies. I don't even know why you got mad at me, but like we were like arguing kind of back and forth outside of some show, and then at the end he was basically just like, fuck you then.
That's like the best.
Yeah, that's tight.
That's
dope. And did
you
actually take it?
I think I gave it to somebody. Like,
remember, I
don't want to take it. Like, wait, with what?
Oh, yeah,
I just got arrested. Wait, or you did get arrested and had the molly in your pocket.
How many times did you guys
walk there? Oh, no way.
What was the other time you were arrested for? You trapping on DM?
No.
Push your teeth?
I was just trying to
stuff. That one. Skated feet.
Really?
Punk feet. Skated feet.
Excuse me. And what part of the Virginia?
Duh.
Oh, okay. I went to Ocean City, Maryland at one point, which has absolutely nothing to do with it. It's not even the same state. But it already came out of my mouth before I remembered that it wasn't the same state, so that's the worst place I've ever spent.
It's like so quiet.
How many times have you been arrested?
I have never been arrested for that.
Really?
Yeah, I don't bring drugs in the car. I think that's what helps the most. Mostly people who I know better. I don't know how I've been arrested. Not that weird. It's probably funny sometimes.
Please stop talking about it.
Charges coming soon.
No, you ever think about it? If that like happened, then the cops decided they wanted to just break in here some night. We do a lot of non-critical music podcasts.
Cops and then like four people.
Yeah, like people. That's why I don't get to speak out.
Well, Uber is chill.
Uber is chill.
You can do drugs in front of Uber.
Like,
Uber
is like Uber.
One time I got into Uber Lil Peep, and I have a picture of it. Maybe I could show it at some point. I got in, bro. I had just like 10 lines.
Oh my god.
Right next to me. He was deep.
I was in the pool?
Yeah,
it was early.
It was the driver.
What time was it? It was like 8 in the morning.
Yeah, got in.
Wasn't it the driver?
He had his iPad, yeah. His iPad was just covered in lines of blood. It's like sitting like right like, in between us. Like, in my
blood. Hey,
it's
something.
It's like,
and we were.
See, all right. There's so many things wrong with that, though. Like, number one, turbulence when driving. That shit's gonna go flying if you take a quick right turn. Number two, how do you know that you're not gonna pick up some fucking nun or some Christian soldier?
I don't think you do. I don't think you do both.
He probably just does it all night to stay there.
He was like a wholesome man, though. He wasn't like. Right.
He was a wholesome man.
Cocaine's a wholesome drug. But, you would never even try it until you came to downtown LA. Okay. Yeah.
That shit.
Oh, you guys are still gonna do this even though you all have fucking songs about girls doing coke up your nut sacks and shit.
It's all marketing.
It's called marketing. Balling out for the podcast, bro. You guys are all like fucking straight prison lifestyle over here trading cigarettes and shit.
Yo, we got beef on cigarettes.
You know what I'm saying? No, you didn't. If I smoked the whole cigarette right now, I would call it.
You don't smoke cigarettes?
I got a blunt that was on something, but I got some
cigarettes. You know,
I can't be smoking them. You know what I'm saying?
No, people are going to happen because Keith has already said like 10 times as many words as he said on the last podcast that he was on the list. People were not very happy
about it. That's because I'm on Bennett.
Are you?
Yes.
Hell yeah.
And he's like,
woo!
Well, but that was a very different time in your life. What was the.
I don't remember shit. I don't remember last week.
Really?
Yeah.
You're just living in this little days, huh?
I'm just in a day. It's weird. But I'm going to get out of this thing. I've been smoking weed for last week.
You feel like that's like medication that's helping you to stay away from all the bad stuff?
Yeah. Oh shit, I just took a couple
of things. A couple? Jesus
Christ.
What? It's going down.
But,
you know what a fan was?
What's wrong with. Wait.
it's a lot.
Xanax 2017.
Xanax 2017.
Just fall asleep.
Keep Xanax 2017.
Keep Xanax a lot.
I love
Xanax.
Does he?
I'm not. Let you know.
Yeah, we're knocking on 12 Xanax right now.
Damn. Yeah. All right, we said I'm gonna wait. You know, like a knock, right? All right, serious question time. Tracy, what made you move to LA? How did it come together from your perspective?
I wouldn't have came if it wasn't
What? You just recognized your talent and started to mess with you, or what?
Yeah, pretty much. But at that time, I was excited for people to work with, like, beats and shit. And he sent me like 30 songs. But the difference, I say, Lil Tracy is more for the people.
Lil Tracy is just
someone's actual friend.
He was like the younger brother of Lil Tracy. Kind of. And he was all.
I thought the younger brother.
How many forms are there, dude? How many forms are there? You know,
all the songs.
I know that form, but I'm saying, like, when he makes like evolution.
Wait, what?
When he makes evolution.
But is that the first time you ever got that?
No, I think it was a trace.
You got it in Uber. But it's always Wiz? Always. Oh my god, that's so funny to like boring ass white people. Wiz Khalifa has like a monopoly on just being a black guy with tattoos and short guys. Yeah.
Fucking Wiz Khalifa. This is tight.
I love that fucking Wiz.
Not a bad one, yeah. Fuck a lot of hunger over the years, so judging that.
Cool guy. Yeah. Cool. Yeah. Real cool guy.
Shout out to every single person on our interview. For real, Lil Peep. Let's just make that clear.
Except.
Gungah.
No.
Except B.O.B.
Who was apparently on the left. It's like you didn't even recognize him. Just sitting. No, and Donald Trump too. We want to check him out. It's just too risky right now.
He's cool.
Right?
I got B.O.B. on my next album.
So were you fascinated with him or what?
Yeah, you had
it. Bobby
Ray.
Wait, did he change that to his name or did he used to be?
This is other man.
I know everything.
Isn't that what he's
called? If you got any questions about BOB, you can go.
I think it was BOB after he was Bobby Ray.
He was Bobby.
I remember reading what BOB
was about. He had watches on watches.
You guys have your own voice.
He believes in the flat earth theory.
Wait, you told me he's been saying Bosch.
No. I heard Curb say Bosch in a song.
For those who don't know, this is Bosch.
He's my OG.
And he might have been the Bosch.
He's never
been
the
Bosch. He was before me. Curb was at my first group.
Really? He bought us right.
That's how Red Side comes.
He's one of the first people I produced.
One of the first people who I started producing.
Did things change when you guys started doing stuff together? Because I feel like you guys kind of
a lot changed involved. When we met each other, you know what I'm saying? We just powered up, leveled up, you know what I'm saying?
Kind of crazy,
yeah.
Yeah, but from a musical perspective, did you guys just kind of like...
Honestly, from a spiritual perspective.
It just came also naturally, like...
Yeah. I saw that, like, when I would go out and, like, the trees would speak to me in, like, all different ways.
I just want to know who was the first one, because I can't tell if like Tracy heard you singing to these hoes and was like, damn, I'm gonna sing just like you. or if it was more like he was doing it and you were sort of like, I'm gonna sing. Because you guys like, you don't even really rap that much anymore. You guys are just singing.
I feel like we both.
Yeah, it just seems like
we
both
But when we collab, it's just that we just like
it just came. We didn't like sit down.
I don't even remember how it happened. You don't really remember.
It was past the game,
but what was special about that?
That's crazy.
I moved out there. Yeah, I moved out there in 2014 and tried to fucking do it. Couldn't do it. Came back to New York and then finally.
Couldn't do it? Like, you made
me. I couldn't mix myself. I don't know how to mix. It's like hard. I taught myself. Yes. I do it all in the garage now. And I engineer myself. A lot of people are like, fuck what you use engineering. And that's what you guys, so.
Why? Because of the way you engineer your own shit? Because that kind of has some effects on your shit. I get what you're saying though, because it does sound different than some other people. It's different, but I don't really know enough about it to translate.
Tell them how you started your career.
I forget. I just look at the future, you know, it's doing
what you're trying to put works. It's fucking history, you know, the videos are so long. What is the deepest shit that we could find up here you guys on?
You made me believe it's called Facebook.
You control this Facebook, why not? Just like,
he didn't know how to say it. Am I smoking weed?
Runs through our Facebook.
One puff shoddy.
You're gonna break up the knives.
He's gonna like run out of here.
He's gonna set those clothes up, some phones on it.
It's like a virus. I was PCP, bro.
Somebody told me it would live, give it to me in like a dabber or some shit. I did it. It was like PCP. Or it was a GCP.
Oh.
It was PCP.
Are you serious?
No, it was DMT.
Probably.
It was last
Is that the only time you've ever been tripping and taking drugs?
No, when people are tripping, like, can we change? I was broke or alcohol. Like, give me in my sleep too. Please stop.
It's an innocent.
Do you guys have ketamine?
No, honestly, I fucking hate that shit.
Dre was like, if
someone gave it to me, I said that was ketamine.
Everybody is just, you don't have a mic, keep conscious, so it's like, because movies are good to hear you.
Yeah, I know.
Alright. Tell me something
weird as shit, bro.
Why? What's the last?
You've never done
it? I did a little munchie one time, but I don't think I really got the full
point.
You
get
it,
like, I'm
like,
it's like a
hell myself.
Really?
Yeah, bro. It's like
people are always mixing it up though, so is that like fucking traveling or is that scary?
So
really?
I've never done that. We've all been there.
Don't do that.
Don't do drugs, but if you're gonna go in the exact way that we describe on this show.
It's about the music.
It is about the music. But I feel like what you guys are probably separating drugs and the music because you guys seem like
it's kind of the same thing.
Yeah, exactly. That's what it is.
It's kind of the same, you know, Tom Denver, you know what I'm saying? What genius isn't crazy?
Wow, okay. Kind of less again right there. That's name one genius that ain't crazy.
Yeah.
There you go.
Yes.
Grow them. So it's Halloween. Let's talk about Halloween. What do you guys think about ghosts and ghouls? You guys go to any haunted houses? No, Siri carving.
I went to that one like in Anaheim like a couple weeks
ago. I fuck with all ghosts and ghouls. Shout out to every ghost and ghoul.
Shout out to O2 golf crew, London rules.
God, but we're all looking like
goblins.
Oh, especially you guys.
Goblins are underrated.
Facts. Like, what's it doing to a goblin?
Yeah, what was he getting at with that?
I don't know.
You just say that. I feel like people always coming at a little bit, but not doing like
shadow
hard.
Right, because there's because people are going to be like, we're going to send our goons at you, and he's saying, well, I'm not a goon, I'm like a goblin, which is the next. A goblin is an evolution of a goon, like if a goon Pokemon
like,
evolved,
what does a goblin look like?
Like, you know, like Tough God.
No, I know, but I mean, like, it wasn't a goon.
You're asking if like a goon is like a
it's like a creature.
Yeah, like a specific. Or do you ever watch Power Rangers?
Yeah.
Remember don't the, know what that
remember
is.
Remember the Punnies?
Never heard of it. There were these guys.
Okay, remember SpongeBob?
No. I haven't seen that one.
I just saw the
thing. I was not on the
I remember. That might be one of the better quotes of this podcast. I remember SpongeBob because I wasn't on Xanax yet then. Anyway, back to pumpkins. Tracy looked really weird.
I did look like Pan once. That was
Tracy didn't take a pumpkins.
We're determined to talk about fucking drugs this entire podcast, which I'm
just
gonna
do it.
It's
not
even
talking about it. It's not even change subject.
Okay. As long as we're gonna change subjects, can I talk about the fact that me and Ned were just walking to the corner store, and people who watch this podcast know that there's a hot, light-skinned girl who works at the corner over there. And Ned was like, yo, this girl's so cute. And I was like, yeah, true, but she's super religious.
My girlfriend gonna beat me up.
Bro!
Ned, that's
bro!
Oh, he's shook. And then, but then she was in there talking about the color of Moses' eyes. It's not like Ned doesn't chase with this girl, even I know.
She's a
Christian.
More of my type.
What, you put a lot of religious people?
No, I'm just a man. What? I'm trying to kill this bug you got over here.
Really?
Yeah, it's cool.
Damn,
it's
super cool.
That's nice. Nice. That's fucked up.
Yeah, hey, bro. Nah.
What's the east side of the hoods,
bro? You take the girls out to smoke?
Don't stress me out. What's that?
You take the girls out to smoke?
I take the girls out to smoke, you know what I'm saying?
You have to?
I have to. I don't wanna, you know.
Why, that makes them, like, ugly and, like, I never had a girl.
It's like, it's like.
You never had a girl?
No.
I don't want resin on my diamonds.
Resin on your diamonds? Alright.
That's it, man. That's it. That's
you guys. No resin on your diamonds. So you guys have been wilding out. You got like this new song that sounds like a fucking Slayer song that I was just listening to.
What's the Slayer song?
It is, but it's
Spring of Blood.
It samples it, right?
Yeah, that was my idea.
To sample
to me.
So you guys are just going in a fucking.
Like, shout out my spot.
Who's that?
Hey,
I smoked
a
session
before.
Oh, that's
not actually, do not. Forget that. I would try to get a shout out.
Why?
I'm saying
that. What? It doesn't blow on my mind. What about the money team?
Fuck smoke.
What's up?
The money team? Like Floyd Mayweather. You ever see like white trash dudes with the TNT hat?
Yeah, I'm like so happy in the whole sports world.
Right.
What is Scott?
You guys don't play or watch sports? This is what we should be talking about.
Oh, man. 2K.
What's the word?
But sports. Shout out sports. Shout out sports, but I don't participate.
You don't like
sports? I used to play. You didn't play sports?
I played sports.
What'd you play?
I played baseball.
I played field hockey.
I was nice at baseball.
What position?
Did you play field hockey?
And baseball?
What catcher?
I don't know. I switched off. I'd be like, I played catcher for a little bit. I didn't
know. Oh, first grade.
You play field hockey?
Yeah, it's only.
Is it?
I know how to play.
I was thinking, is field hockey the same as lacrosse?
Nah. That's Canadian, so he plays weird sports.
I play hockey.
Oh, shout out Canada.
You guys are in Canada.
I play inline hockey.
I've been in Canada. Shout out to Toronto.
Inline hockey. Really?
Yeah.
You're on inline skates playing hockey?
Yes.
I would love to see some photos of that.
I can probably find some someday.
Imagine that. Yo, so. When did you guys decide you wanted to be the goth boy? Like, that's why. Where did the name come from, and why was it B-O-I or B-O-I?
I think Chris could help with that.
Prime Chris.
I don't fully know, really.
Oh, geez.
Like, honestly, but like, because it was it was like Wicked Phase and like,
why you
and like Cold Heart, that kind of
name
chair, and
Chris.
It was like the
Chris pull the chair.
Pull the chair.
Yeah.
Wait, pull the chair.
Yeah, that's
Chris. Here he is on that.
Real remix,
slide it over.
Yeah, so I don't know, I guess when you get like Cold Heart and Wicked Phase on, they can tell you, but it was kind of like they were the founders of the group and everybody else kind of came after.
I'm a new group.
Yeah, shout out Lil Peep. I'm a
little
banger.
Tell me your whole roster of it.
Yeah, who's the Cold Heart, fucking Wicked Phase, or just something kind of neat, by the way. I didn't watch the anime, but I watched the freestyle. Yeah. Not freestyle, but doing that.
Yeah,
song.
I just had
it. It was a freestyle. Yeah. Not freestyle.
It was. No, it's a new song. It's like his new single from his album.
But it seems like I kind of mean it seems like they're doing. Well, no, they do it live.
Yeah,
but
it's
like,
in his real studio, but it's a live performance.
It seems like it's like freestyle, like basically like they're doing it one take, but I'm pretty sure they did a few takes. But that was pretty good. So where's he from? You guys ended up linking up with him?
Scranton.
Scranton.
Real shout out to the office.
Yeah. The fucking.
That's where the office came from.
Well, it was where it was said to take place. Because one time I was driving through there on a trip, and one of my friends was like, yo, we gotta stop and like see all the stuff in the show. I'm like,
you
have to film this shit in California. No, I'm not.
I'm not. Why drive it?
Oh, you see that?
Yeah, pink eye. You
somebody farting your somebody farting your pillow.
What's going on?
You know, usually when you have pink eye, people are like, oh, do they eat booty? Well, yeah, I think I did it.
I thought you got brown eyes.
It's from getting like fecal particles in your eye.
I think that probably happened
to me. Low key, that's how contagious you're endangering us.
It's not that bad. I don't actually think it's a big guy. I think I just had a piece of dust like in my eye.
A piece of poop dust?
Yeah, poop dust. Straight out of my butthole. So let me ask you that. Have you ever rapped your little animals on your buttholes in your life? Or what?
Is there more buttholes?
Yes.
Yes.
No, shout out buttholes sometimes.
Shout out buttholes.
No, shout out butt gang.
Young Goth just said, shout out buttholes.
So Horsehead, how'd you get involved with all these guys? Talk to us, baby.
It all really was just like me and Ned had linked up and were roommates when we both had first moved to Ivan, LA.
Yeah, because you've been here for a bit longer than used to.
Yeah, but I just moved from Orange County.
Right.
But when I came out here, me and him linked, and that's when the whole Brax House thing happened. And then he came out here, and me and him just became really close. And then basically we just added into GothboiClique, like after we had been making music and stuff together for a while, living together.
Nice.
It's called Hearts from Long Beach, though.
Right.
We were all real close.
Where did it change that just happened? What is the shit?
It's the Cure.
Well, that's cool.
But it's handmade, I got it today.
What, it's like a drawing of the guy from the Cure?
That's or sweet.
It says the Cure on it, too.
Thank you.
You got a long ass armpit hair, bro. You should braid that.
I have long armpit hair.
You still got the pinky? Look at this pinky.
What?
Holy shit. What? Are you good luck?
I said personal on braids. And
I could braid my shit.
You should not.
Let's get it.
Look where you can, like, you know, it's like 10,000 likes on Instagram, probably.
So you're saying you're the real Iverson?
No. Tracy and Green.
That's Tracy and Green.
Make more sense. So what, you want to catch post?
I'll play as well.
Yes. Oh, but you want to fight him too, or just?
He doesn't want to fight.
Let's get it cracking here.
Nah, I don't want to debate.
Need the fame.
I think Post Malone is real cool.
Yeah, that's what I was gonna say. He's probably the
best. I've met him once. I feel like he's
better. Wait, really?
He was like at one show.
I won't say names, but some underground rappers that I know have told me that Post Malone was a huge fan of theirs before he blew up, so...
I don't know. He was awesome.
That's how... Hey, is everybody in the mainstream just steal culture from the underground now?
Shit.
Yeah, right. Let's talk about it.
100%. Yeah, but shout out to them.
And shout out to them for monetizing.
I'm on my douchebag radio shit, you think?
Is that what you're aiming for, or what?
I'm just trying to be like if I could say, like, one person...
If you could save one person, what are you talking about?
If I could say like who I want to be like the most and all this shit.
Okay.
Probably like Horsehead. Probably
just Horsehead. You said that Horsehead right before that someone said GK. I took away the momentum.
You know what I'm trying to be like?
Which photo?
Cash photo.
What is that? Leave that he said.
Hawaii, I do.
That's.
Demi Lovato.
Demi Lovato.
I just wanted those IDs off Hollywood Boulevard.
Rock star. Demi Lovato. What is this, like a hooker?
No.
Dude, it's like a fake ID that they sell on like Hollywood Boulevard.
Can you just call Demi Lovato a hooker?
I don't know who Demi Lovato is,
bro.
Favorite song recorded is Stronger. Favorite colors are red and black.
You would know.
Surfing hates rumors.
He doesn't know who Demi Lovato is.
No, I don't. I'm not fucked up, man.
You know who that is.
You don't even know who the putties were from Power Rangers.
Bro, you don't know who Demi Lovato is.
Do you want me to fucking Google this right now? Am I totally blowing it? Is she like a famous 80s singer or something?
That's what she's doing.
You're
just
gonna tell me that she fucking had like ham last week or something. Look at the fucking guys.
And he's looking up who Demi Lovato is.
On the podcast. I'm not going to let you guys
know. That's 2016, Brad.
Well, you know when you type in Demi, you know the first thing that comes up on Google is Demi Lovato. So that apparently she's very famous.
Yeah, she's very famous.
She's
doing
it. She's like Disney Channel. She's like Disney Channel.
She's like our age. She's 24.
Wow, 49.1 million dollars. That is a lot. She gets a million likes on every photo.
What do you mean?
It's like you're a singer, songwriter, and actress.
Yes.
Am I the only person on earth who doesn't know?
Yes.
Or in LA. I mean, it's not that big of a deal, but like.
Well, she's from Houston. So I mean, yeah. I'm not gonna lose a lot more in the future. But let's talk about her career, not about you guys. Does it read off? I thought it was gonna have the illustration showing like someone's ID to the camera. I thought it was gonna have like vital information on there. So let me ask you this, Tracy. You get a lot of bars these days that are very like they almost remind me
iconic.
Of like, yes, iconic. Because I can't fuck with you unless you're friends with my space. Sometimes I feel like you are writing like song like lyrics that are meant to be people's AIM profile bios.
Yeah.
Or there are way
more. Like something to tweet or something.
Something to tweet. Yes, Drake is that's why Drake stands out to me, very tweetable with lyrics.
Yeah, exactly.
This is funny. I used to think of that when I was writing.
Really?
Almost people like that too.
No, totally. That's, I think, almost the best thing you could say about a lyric or about a verse is that this is something that people want to repeat.
Yeah.
Not even just tweeting, just quoting.
Just want to repeat, yeah. Like certain lines just stick in your head. That's what rappers should never say to memory, even though they're little white kids.
That's what I was thinking. But sometimes I still say it.
No, totally, I understand. But as a white kid, I can tell you that there's been many, many times in my life that I wanted to tweet a lyric and that I couldn't.
And it's weird when you see it.
I barely even retweet that one.
I mean, I feel like that's kind of like the environment.
Ginger saying.
That's the environment, though. For
like, why does this shit hurt? I have a fucking tattoo on.
Like, yourself on fire.
I just got a new tattoo yesterday. It's a wine glass instead of more wine.
Hey, can we talk
about wine, actually?
Hey, I heard about this incident where a girl said something racist to you at a party recently, and I'm sure you know exactly what I'm talking about, right?
Oh, yeah.
Well,
no, let's talk about that. No, let's forget about that.
Fuck that girl.
She got aired out already. Let's forget about that.
What, it was on that Ned's place?
No, we kind of.
It was like a misunderstanding.
It's all good. We kind of put our fans on her Instagram.
You know, I don't know anything about her. I just know that I didn't go. And then when I came back, Vegan was like, told me, like, oh, somebody called Tracy at the party. No. And it got crazy.
It was somebody else.
That was somebody else.
It wasn't her that said it.
Somebody went out with a taser and it was all this bullshit.
It wasn't her that actually said it.
She was like, fuck that story. It's too broken. Yeah. No one knows what it is.
Really?
Yeah. No one knows.
I don't want to say too much. Because
yeah, that's some bullshit. We're not even on that.
Yeah, it's in the past.
Well, that's good.
We pull up to the party and we're trying to fight.
People try to kill you.
They do? You guys the problems? What, about what?
Everything, bro.
It's like security at shows and shit.
Yeah.
You should be
sometimes. We get online bullied.
Yeah. Do you guys really get cyberbullied? About what?
I get cyberbullied.
Especially when
I love it, man.
Do you really get cyberbullied? About what?
About everything.
I think your region's
looks. Yeah, how could you not hate
like,
me?
All of us, I swear.
It's because we're different, I guess.
You guys are different.
I'll give
you that. Fuck, that's
crazy. Fucking outcast.
The only person I feel like I ever heard talk shit about Pete like publicly was Anthony Fantano.
It's a lot of.
Fuck Anthony Fantano.
Who is that? I was needle dropping.
Fuck me. Fuck me.
No
one
should. No one should review music. That's all opinions.
The needle point.
But anyway, people just get nice and homophobic and get any racist.
You get a lot of that.
Yeah, we all get a lot of that shit. Everyone does it even nowadays.
Because we don't care about that shit.
We're cool with everybody, so.
Yeah. That's fucked up, though. You want to say somebody's fucking ugly or don't like him or whatever. That's one thing. Yeah. Don't call him fucking gaylord or whatever. Yeah. Let us be gay. You know, like, let's try.
Yeah. Yeah. But we're not even.
No, but don't give him that.
We're not here.
Let's leave it ambiguous. No, I know you're not.
Like some conversation.
Are we all strictly heterosexual at this table? That almost seems rare since sexual gender exists on a spectrum.
Gender fluid.
Yeah, we're all gender fluid. Yes, thank you for saying that. No, but gender fluid. Okay, you know what that is? It's where like you could be like, yes, I'm like a man right now, but like later I'm gonna feel like a woman, and so you should have to call me like a her later on. When
did
I,
you hear that young thug said he went to jail? He would like try to become a woman.
He said he was gonna get busted.
Yeah, so he could be with the girl. That's kind of smart.
I need that.
I think, oh, that's a cool.
Who cares? I need that collab.
Young Thug class, dude, bro. That would be fire.
Be solid.
I just let people be people and not ask them questions, you know?
But I was.
Why are we even talking about this shit?
What about?
We're gonna do whatever they want anyway.
What were we talking about? I was about to talk about being in
jail. Gender. Wait, I'm talking about positivity.
That's what I'm saying.
Right,
let's talk about flexing.
Flexing.
This is, you got the vintage Polaris jacket on.
Yeah. I just got this on my homie today.
Really?
Yeah. You can't, you know what I'm saying? You want to go try to find these bitches at your shoe store. You're going to have a hard time.
What kind of shoe
store?
I got a size 12 foot and a fucking, you know what I'm saying?
13 over here.
Yeah.
Bro.
Okay. Oh, I guess it's,
didn't I say it at 13 size? I put this thing,
bro. You guys were talking about my foot size?
Yes.
Wow, that's fire.
We talk about it every night, dude. Literally, bro.
Every night.
At least 20 minutes.
You're the number one guy.
Motherfucker. He's up, too. No, you know what? This
now, we have to quit.
Oh, let's go.
Oh, yeah, where's the
book? Let's do this all day.
We left the book. All right, here's the first question.
Okay.
All right, so it said, who is Adam? Let's get spiritual.
I'm Adam, and I don't consider myself spiritual. I don't
so you're an atheist?
Yes, and I don't believe in spirit. But I don't really know how to take the word spiritual. I do believe that, you know,
man,
I don't know how to really like talk about spirituality, but I do believe that spirituality can exist outside of like God and like having to believe in those things.
Yeah. Energy.
Jesus.
Am I an atheist?
What's that one?
I believe in a higher power, but I have no idea what it is. And I just don't ask questions. I just let it go.
And try to do what's right.
Do what's right is what I think the
which, you know,
most important thing is. Yeah. Yeah.
Do what's right.
You're pretty wrong. You need to cook. Grill. Grill. People are weirded up on that about like eating pizza in there. Isn't it? Like,
man, I almost ordered food.
I was supposed to do that the other day, and I went to eat a big ass sandwich.
You were surprised no one got caught by it.
See.
Would that be like a problem?
If you couldn't see any of it, then it would be okay.
You'd be like all the way down.
If you couldn't see any of it, it would technically be okay. Which is like
implied top.
I mean, I got my ass licked for the first time ever sitting right here. The camera just wasn't on.
Underrated.
Oh, yeah. Right here. That's my
favorite. Wait, you're not into having booty clips? You seem like you're probably into it.
Bro, I have never. How do we? That's just 100% honest. I have never.
The weirdest.
And I'm married to that. Low key, whenever anything goes weird, I'm like, it's just not me.
From the way Tracy's laughing, I'm thinking that he agrees too.
It's just
not me. He's just like, what are we talking
about? I'm not with you. Don't put.
No.
he said he doesn't want you to put his
don't put it on.
Even though he has nothing to say, but he's just laughing his ass off.
Yeah, yeah. Put it in for sure.
100%. Okay. So are you guys influenced by this is a real like interview question. It's not about eating ass or like joining a racist gang in prison or whatever we're talking about before.
What were we talking about?
No, we were talking about prison for a second though, right?
Racist.
No, that's what I was going to bring up. That's what I was going to say is like, that's what sucks though, is that when you, everybody else,
yeah,
you
were talking about trading cigarettes.
Everybody I know, anytime you see a documentary about jail, go to jail, you immediately get put in shit gangs based on their race. And I'm
scared of that.
Like prison. I'm already gone.
Like real jail. Yeah. Like real jail. That's kind of scary right there. That you'd all of a sudden have to like.
I mean, that's a gang.
Yeah, that would suck. You don't have to do that.
That would be the worst.
I mean, but yeah, but I don't think it works like that. I think they let you just switch sides. It's not like outside where you just kind of one day you're caught.
You
want
something. To stay out of these private, like, you know what I'm saying? These
well,
privately owned prisons, you know what I'm saying? They're just sort of making money and putting people in cages and just hold them.
You guys should have a song about like, the election.
We should make something about the election.
Yes. Thank you.
What
is that?
I'm about to get very political on everybody once they get a little bit more, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
my boy.
I seen one play for Donald Trump at a huge festival, and there was like a lot of people that seemed like they weren't into it, and that was kind of strange.
You seen what?
There was like a lot of people that seemed like they weren't into the fuck Donald Trump song.
That's weird.
Yeah.
Oh, low key, I just said fuck Donald Trump and I lost a few fans.
Really?
Yeah, because there was the number one fan in the first place.
Fuck Donald Trump. Hey man, there's a lot of people who hate Hillary so much that they're just rocking the Donald Trump.
I mean, fuck Hillary too, but fuck Donald Trump.
Oh. Okay, you guys ready?
Like we're in like the 1960s or some shit. Like everyone's weird.
It is, it's like weird.
A lot of tension and shit.
A lot of low key racial tension that they haven't necessarily felt bubbling up like this in a long time. And
not,
like
not over here though. Over here.
Yeah, not over here.
That is a good point. Not over here at all.
It's all about. I don't know what the buzz
we're the new
person.
Alright, this is my interview question. What music are you guys influenced outside of hip hop? Because you guys kind of remind me a lot of like pop punk type stuff a lot of times.
Yeah, I like the mainstream shit, like all like the mainstream.
Follow the
fire. Was that something you guys would listen to as kids?
I like
probably
not Tracy as much. I grew up from
I was like on Fall Out Boy.
So what did you grow up
listening
to?
You know the
time. Yeah, I think
I got deeper into it.
Me and Tracy both like this band called Wild, I think.
I also
listen to
a lot of like. I like Tycho a
lot. I hardcore.
See, I don't know what you're talking about. The Northwest stuff, like fucking what was it like rock?
You see a lot of bands and shit.
Yeah. Oh, okay.
You need to see that.
What kind of hardcore band are you?
Fuck, I don't know. New York, NYC, New York hardcore.
Wow. Yeah, no, but what, like,
it's like
era?
Made in NYC. That was a classic.
Nice.
Even though, I don't know.
Did you ever see yourself just
like,
sing for a band?
What?
Did you ever sing for a band at a certain point?
No, I never did. I probably should have. I probably still will at some point in my life.
It's a good flex for a
band. When I'm, like, really, really rich. I'm starting to because that costs a lot of money. It costs way more money to, like, tour as a band.
And you get paid less than a split six ways with a fucking drummer.
And you gotta ship all the you gotta ship all the fucking
so much shit.
Equipment.
Bring a drum kit with you?
Yeah, we got it. It's crazy.
Yeah. Have you guys really like toured much lately? Like have you been out for a long period of time?
I'm actually for the first time ever. I'm about to
get
to
the
end.
Are you excited?
Shout out to that album tables.
That's one perfect.
It's not a song.
That's
one
perfect.
Yeah. I leave the 27th. And I'm gonna be on tour for like a whole month, so it's the first time I've really been on like a big tour. Other than that, it's been like 3 days, the longest I've been on tour. But yeah, I'm excited.
Do you think you're gonna make it?
Yeah, I'm gonna make it.
I can see you like getting left in fucking Kentucky or something.
Fuck
like, just
yeah,
stay there. You mean the right thought and just staying with the right thought.
It should be like a
the right
I don't know if I would call what rappers do on tour a dating show. I would call it more like a fucking show, man.
It should be Love and Hip Hop Underground.
Yeah, a lot of people have said that, and that would be fucking awesome.
That should be tried.
That's basically one of the
darkest. That's harder.
Anything.
No Jumper is Love and Hip Hop Underground, but it's just people sub-dissing each other on the podcast. Like, girls come on talking about some guy with a small dick, and there's some guy that already got interviewed, and he's just sitting there, just like, God, that's me.
God!
I don't know.
I'm never about that.
Yeah. What, where were we?
Where are we?
They told me, we're just all over the place. Somebody told me I shouldn't be scared of the gaps in the conversation. They're like, don't
never
be scared. Just leave the gaps because then people will start talking.
I'm high off the one you're leaving.
I can tell. I knew.
not saying shit. Usually you're like,
and that is kind of quiet on the podcast usually. I feel like toxic.
When he was on it though, he talked too much.
Oh my god, yes.
That was great. That was probably one of the best.
That shit was good.
Throwback moment right there.
Good
that shit was funny.
That was valuable content.
That was very good. That might have been like the fifth one.
Yeah, very good.
That's crazy. Yeah. Go back and look at Young Ned. Remember when you were here with Nicoletti and Cuddle Beard Woman?
Yeah, that was when I first met him. Shout out my friend Nate.
Because I saw a picture you wearing that exact outfit with the big ass earrings. It was like a fucking chandelier.
He called me a Muppet on a fucking like vlog, and all these fucking fans were like, you do look like a Muppet.
Oh my god. I didn't know about that.
Let's tell him about what you guys are working on.
Well,
as corny as that sounds.
I have another good, real interview question.
Let's see it.
You want to hear this?
I just joined you.
I'm a big fan of the song.
Oh my god.
Gods, where you guys sort of rap back and forth. What was the creative process like writing that song? You know, having an engineer a verse together.
We were in the
I engineered it and skid row. It took us about 20 minutes to make the entire song. We don't remember doing it. It happened in 20 minutes. And we posted it let's just post it. Shout out to the band, because the beat is fire. And look, he said that, listen closely, it says that.
Tracy. Oh, what is that part? What
I swear it says Tracy, man. I don't know what it says, but I swear I can.
Tracy and the people.
That's what it says.
So you really don't remember? You guys have a lot of classic songs that just, they work, but then you don't really remember the creative process?
Nah.
Same for Pete.
Like with Cassidy. Well,
that was like the,
what do you call it?
I don't know what happened. I don't even learn. Yeah, it's Castle. Like, I don't even know how that happened. It was just on the internet, low key. Like, now it's just like on the internet. And I'm like, how, where? I don't know where we made that.
Yes, you do. It was in Cortex and some upsold Airbnb up in Hollywood. Like, way up there. Remember?
The one with the roof.
Is that where we shot?
Yeah.
We were working on it there. I'm pretty sure. Off top. Did we do that in one night?
It was like two days.
I was gonna be on that song too, and then I just went home because it was not late.
Which song?
Castle.
Oh, damn, that's rare.
That's cool though. These songs just come out of the fucking ether. Do you think you just have to be in the right emotional state?
I barely ever work on music.
It just comes together.
No. Yeah.
Yeah, bro. But I sit down. Like, I will not do shit for a whole week, and then I sit down for like 2 hours.
Like,
and make like ten songs.
You can make 10 songs in a night.
Fuck yeah.
Really?
I've seen him wake up and make like six songs.
I can't do this.
It takes me like four or five days.
All my albums I made in probably like not even a week.
4 or 5 minutes, but you have the and then what? You just like rewrite the lyrics over and over, or what?
What do you mean?
Like,
I just sit there, I listen to the beat, and I write the lyrics on my notes, and then boom, I record it, and then I add them up into a collection. It takes me like a day or two to make the whole thing, and then I got a album.
What about
you?
Yeah,
it won't work for like a
whole month. So when I record by myself, I don't write, I just like, do like feelings, and then it's like a project, like a book assignment or some shit, I'm just like,
do you like record a version and then listen to it and then all of a sudden you're like, nah, I need to change like this one word.
Yeah,
you know, like little parts.
Fucking around with melodies. I'm not even good at ad-libs.
You mean you know that?
Do you guys do ad-libs?
I sing ad-libs.
I don't really.
If you listen to my shit, I like singing. I'm trying to remember some of that shit. If you hear one of my lines, I like singing it afterwards.
Or do like melodies.
Yeah, some shit.
You guys heard of Rock Youngster?
I've seen that name, but I haven't
heard of
it.
He's like a crazy motherfucker from down south, but the other day I was listening to a song and he said, come and suck on my dick. Lil Dick!
Bolo said, I swear, as an ad lib in the song.
I swear.
Juicy J is like standing at the very back. District! Like, the lyric doesn't even make sense unless you include the ad. I like that.
Yeah.
That's very playful. That's very, joyous way. Who you guys got beef with? You don't want to fight. Let's talk about that.
Nobody.
No one. I honestly want to just give everyone a hug.
Okay. Well, mine was a loaded question. I didn't really think you guys were going to have a serious answer to that. I just wanted to see what you'd say.
No beef.
No beef at all. Everyone, you know, I love everybody.
Who's somebody you'd like to see worse than get fucked up about?
Nobody.
I couldn't even think of
I would never.
Who could take me?
Who could take
me? I can't really see Horsley getting fucked up by anyone, to be honest with you.
Well, it's because he's got a con, probably, yeah.
He probably, I put money down, he would knock out Conor McGregor and, like, fit. Like, Horsley has hands, bro.
Conor McGregor, that's a bullshit.
Who is that?
Conor McGregor, Horsley wants to fight.
We should at least
for charity.
No, you think that he could take on like Ronda Rousey?
Gonna start something real.
Ronda Rousey versus Morsad, like charity exhibition wrestling.
How about Rosie O'Donnell?
Rosie O'Donnell and my sexual bridal shower. Do you guys love that? Oh, man, it's gonna sound so crazy if you guys don't remember that freestyle. We have been doing this for a little less than an hour.
Tracy has a show up for this.
Where is that show?
I just
want to
type
it out. Well, Tracy, we're a show.
He doesn't feel that
much. Oh,
yeah. So, I'm not even the one that's the first that we have some more time.
Yeah, we'll talk about the rest of the morning. Let's do it. I want you guys to just admit that you've done coke smell documents.
Never. That'd be hard.
He's the one talking on the song. I assume that he speaks for all of it.
Off your nuts?
Off his
I'm
nuts.
Gonna speak it.
Brad?
A buck. Like a buck. The thumbs up.
Like a buck.
Like a buck.
That's a lit shit.
But you know what the thing is? You gotta make sure your balls and your dick are like real dry before you start doing it. Because you have the liquid on your dick.
You're talking about that sweaty balls.
You're saying it all in
average.
So you gotta hit it with the acid. Yeah, it's a whole thing. No, because it happened to me and the girl started snorting off my dick and it's like a fucking paste. The way she's just snorting. Because then I got a slobber all over it.
Yeah.
Shut up the heart, she's probably listening right now. I picture death on this in the But yeah, having paste all over your dick, that's awesome. So don't get Leon.
Toilet paper.
Toilet paper on your dick? Oh, just wipe it.
You never had toilet paper on your dick?
From what? From like wiping my pee off?
From fucking a girl and she had like toilet paper. Am I fucking
this? Nope.
Yes,
no,
you are. But
L.
Nah, but unless you like
L.
She bends over and she's got like a big piece of toilet paper stuck to her vagina.
I could see it in Ned's eyes.
Ned Lover.
Ed.
You were better than
Ed.
Are people gonna like this interview?
How about favorite cartoon?
They're gonna hate it.
I think they're gonna like it.
Yeah, Nate Cullen. How about favorite cartoons? Growing up.
Favorite cartoons growing up.
Oh, that's right.
Arnold.
Tracy was really on that
time.
Yo, Static Shock.
Yeah.
Rocket Power.
Johnny Test. It's pretty new, but like, I was in trouble with this.
I fuck with
Scooby-Doo,
bro. I literally sit on my couch watching Scooby-Doo for days.
I was just never.
I didn't like Scooby-Doo either.
I could watch Scooby-Doo and smoke weed all day.
South Park, I used to watch.
But Scooby-Doo is like low-key about weed.
It is.
Oh,
I heard it was originally supposed to be like on acid, like that was the original writing. And like they were all
going that crazy thing.
Yeah, they were all tripping, and then they were
going to start tripping
that. And then like see
ghosts. That's what you realize when you get older, is that a lot of cartoons are kind of meant to be
taken
by adults.
Bro, SpongeBob started out as an adult. Like,
script.
Little shit like Ren and Stimpy
and you're like, fuck it, let's make this a kid and like an adult comic.
Right.
Yeah. Disney is
sick. They throw all those subliminals in there, so like, Ren and Stimpy.
Because I think a lot of times people start making like a piece of art and then they realize that the only way to make art really popular is to make it popular with kids, because kids are the ones who are like consuming art for the most part. So that's why this podcast probably at some point is going to become about like coloring. How to count.
Cayenne.
We got Lil Peep and Lil Tracy, and we're going to talk about how to put a condom on.
Whoa.
I don't know if any young adult.
Never heard of it.
You don't
wear a condom.
You don't?
No,
you got it. I don't wear a condom.
You don't? Why not? You sound like a lot of people, or mostly women.
I don't either. I don't either. I swear.
You don't have a lot of sex?
I don't have it. Nope.
I don't believe you especially.
What is sex?
What is sex?
Never heard of it.
I'm almost, I feel like I'm at the point in my life where I'm starting to realize I'm that asexual. No matter how much sex I have, I'm, it's not going to make me happy.
You should not.
Tracy was so happy to just hit him with that.
Nah, we always do fucking.
Alright, so I'm gonna ask everybody at the table this question. What does Tracy have in common with Nicki Minaj that you think made him want to compare himself to her in a song? Like, what are they like?
Alright, I got this. This is easy. This is easy.
You can answer that.
No one can deny either of them what they do.
What?
For this music.
There you go.
As a whole.
You just call them
Adam? Yeah. No.
I think, because Nicki Minaj has bitches.
They're both pop stars.
Right. Yeah.
Who gets it?
Fuck you guys. No, that was right too, though.
Yeah.
So, I mean, there's many reasons.
She really
they're
is.
They're colorful. Right. They're both colorful.
She's untouchable. And he's wild. Yeah, you got right there. That's it. That
boss bitches. I get crazy. It's a hard song.
Day two, bro. Maybe I all the songs we're getting booed like this. She was saying foul shit. And then I think when she realized she wanted to be a big pop star, she had to chill a little.
She's like, yeah.
But that's actually crazy when you see Nicki Minaj and she plays this huge stadium. She's probably a little girl. She's singing about like getting nasty and saying all these
shit. That's what Tracy's gonna be doing.
That's Tracy.
Like the end of the year. But that's what Tracy's gonna be sounding out stadium and throw the little girl. You know? Talking about getting coke and no sniff up.
Yeah. But there's nothing wrong with little kids knowing about getting coke sniffed up their nuts. You know what
I mean? I don't know. But she knows.
For the children.
Yeah.
Are you signed?
No, I'm not.
You're not signed?
No.
Are you planning on, is this the conversation you've had with labels or anything? I've seen some stuff online.
The labels be, no. They call me. I ignore them.
Really? You ignore them? So, but do you want to be a big pop star? Or is that what you guys are aiming for or what?
I want 10 million at least.
10 million's a lot. It sounds like a lot.
Yeah, well, give me a couple of years. You know what I'm saying? Give me a year or two. You know what I'm saying?
But do you feel like that's considered like uncool in the underground to be like
fuck the underground?
Fuck the underground.
No, not fuck the underground. I'm just not in the underground.
Fuck though.
I'm doing my own thing. I'm just Lil Peep. And JC.
Yeah, we're just trying to do our
own thing. We got a lot of new shit coming out that's gonna surprise you guys, you know what I'm saying?
But a lot of people are kind of ashamed.
Just wait,
like, right?
Just wait. Give it to
write and catch his hooks. You guys aren't scared to write hooks.
Hook mom.
Do you guys consider yourself talented?
I'm like pretty much Roscoe Dash with the hooks.
That's who you're gonna go with?
He's fire. I mean.
It's Hook Gang.
You can't deny no
all
hands.
All my verses are just hooks.
No hands, one of the best hooks.
It's just like
But it's weird how so many people in the underground kind of like don't want to do choruses, but choruses are usually
I love choruses. I love doing hooks. I would do a hook. I love doing hooks.
The whole castles.
The whole castles. I just did the hooks, and then Tracy did the verse. And that's the same one way with YT, and that's the same way where I'm using Cobain. I just do the hook, and he gets the verse.
But I treat it like a hook.
He treats it like a hook.
You know, so it's really just.
It's just magic. That's just. There's nothing like it in this whole plan. You know what I'm saying?
So, yeah.
I'm just trying to write like actual songs too, with like structure, you know?
Yeah.
Like, beginning.
Course has, you know,
is that something you don't want to do all the time? You don't
know
what
you
I mean, I've just been doing music since I was really young, and like, used to play bands and shit, and write songs on guitar, and then started producing beats and shit after too.
Yeah. So, I would say I really inspired music too.
But so you guys have sort of like a collaborative musical process, is that what you guys are saying? Because you said that he's like killing the writing, he's helping you guys. Does everybody sort of write stuff for each other?
No. Yeah, I write a lot of shit.
Yeah.
I was about to drink.
Sometimes me and Tracy.
I mean, we write. Yeah,
ideas
and shit like that.
I'd say Tracy.
Slug writes for me once.
Really? For the whole verse?
Funny ass shit.
Shout out Slug. I love you,
Slug. Why did that happen? Slug like Tracy. I'm going to write for you. Like, I got you.
Because Slug always looks like you were at 16.
He's the man with the plan, honestly.
You guys know that one Kanye song that GP wrote? GP wrote a Kanye song, and it's so funny when you listen to it. It's just so. Fuck. I can't remember, but it really is, and when you listen to the lyrics, it's so obvious.
Did you know Future wrote Blueberry Yum Yum by Ludacris? He wrote the hook for that.
Blueberry Yum Yum, what is that?
Future wrote a lot of shit, though. It's a Ludacris song.
I know the rest
of it. I'm not the word, it's not Ludacris.
Blueberry. That song's fire.
And I can give you a bottle of Cheeto, too, it's not after one of them, but it made me feel like a total fucking scumbag.
You
sick fuck.
It bothers me that this person has 60 million followers and you guys all know about it and I don't. Clearly just fucking up.
You're fucked.
It's kind of like old news folks though. Old news.
Oh yeah, I find out about everything real quick.
She was getting like kind of hated on movies somewhere.
Talk about Kiki Palmer.
Fuck.
Who's that again?
I found out about Miley Cyrus when she started fucking rappers. I'm just gonna put it back.
You didn't know about it, sir.
I fucked
my because I'm like 10 years older than you guys. She starts fucking around with Mike Will. I'm like, oh, okay, now I know who's this person I've heard.
Mike Will?
She fucked Mike Will.
Wasn't that how she got her name? Was she hanging around him?
I wanted
it. She was at the very least doing music with him, but I kind of assumed that usually they fucked around.
I don't know the facts.
They're probably very business professional.
Are we too straight to like compliment like handsome men in the music industry? Is that that's our code?
No.
Who's a good looking guy?
Everybody here.
Who name a handsome man?
Yeah, of course.
Who's not in the room?
Who's name a handsome man?
Wick your face.
I'm gonna try to do
it. Wick your face.
Core.
Dylan Reed. Dylan Reeder. He's dead, so that's easier for me to say too because I don't have to see him.
He's a good looking guy.
Oh yeah, girls loved him. That was
the Reeder?
Rick Ross.
Rick Ross, so that's what you mean. He has a very different style guy he's into. Rick Ross.
Rick Ross, funky.
Yo, I hate that song.
Dude, it's very
Ruben Studdard.
On the left.
Fuck that shit.
What else are we talking about?
I don't know. The bunch almost done that.
Pete hasn't washed their conditioner hair in years.
Oh yeah, no. I don't put shampoo or conditioner in my hair.
Shampoo ain't good. Shampoo
I don't really do it that often either.
Don't do it. It's
conditioner if anything.
Oh yeah, I don't wash my hair that often. There's not a whole lot of the leather, you know. Wait, but we're just dying in the end. Still up, huh?
I
got a condition.
I got my hair treated a few days ago, you know what I'm saying? I had a penthouse suite.
See, the biggest flex there I was
treated.
Wow. I was on the phone, it was like, I just bought a $40 chicken sandwich.
Yeah, you know.
I don't know, I had $40 chicken sandwich.
Was it good?
What did it do that?
It was buttermilk fried with some nice aioli.
Just go on the reads. Can you search from like the most expensive to least expensive and just go on
the get a mixed chicken.
Hey, what kind of fast food do you guys like?
McDonald's.
Sometimes
shout out McDonald's. I can eat four cheeseburgers.
We do that in Texas every day.
Four new chicken.
Not McDonald's for me.
And two Big Macs.
All that shit's dry.
I had a fistful of
two fries in one sitting.
Bender.
I eat more than I eat in
No, I was looking at Jack in the Box on my curb the other day and thinking like, will I ever go there? And then like, you know,
Jack in the Box tacos.
With Uber Eats, I don't think I'm ever going to go to Jack in the Box or again. You know, because it just opens up your world so much more.
Why is it called Jack in the Box?
I agree. Someone's serving somebody masturbating your food there, yeah.
Oh, Jack in the Box?
Is that what you're doing?
Jack in the
Box.
And the dude is weird.
I can't lie, I love them.
The dude with the big white thing.
It's lime,
yeah. The big circle thing.
I don't want to even say fuck him because he's probably watching.
And because you're coming
with that. Definitely watching. It might be you. We don't know.
I might be the cartoon mascot.
It's a problem. Accusation.
You know? I've heard girls asking me about it.
Asking? Yeah, of course you do.
Yeah. And I'm like, no, don't worry about them. Let's worry about me.
Let's worry about me.
Don't worry about that shit.
Yeah, Pete just turned 20. Big crazy, big happy B-day. Just a kid.
I'm just a kid.
Simple plan.
No, what?
Tell everybody to go follow me.
Well, what's in this here?
Follow my SoundCloud.
SoundCloud.com/gang.
Lil_Peep. My Twitter. @LilP_Shouty. Follow my Instagram @LilP, no underscores, no nothing. I'm verifying that bitch.
Ooh. I'm at the Rich Monopoly Banger Gang. That's me.
At Young Money Tracy.
I can see that. Maybach Ed R. That's me.
What?
Like Maybach Music.
I'm gonna change mine to the real.
What
is
it? What's on mine is real horse then.
Like a gun? Yeah. Had a hell of straps on me since the onion. No, I've never really had a gun. But I'm trying to get a gun this week actually. But it's a 10-day long period, so what I actually need is I'm gonna get a gun like 2 weeks from now. But I don't know.
The strap
handgun or something? I don't know. I know there's something to do. The rappers in here, but maybe one day I might have to kill one.
Whoa!
No. Protect them against the homeless is what I actually meant.
Run!
Alright. I'm glad that this
run!
Didn't happen without anyone being murdered or anything. Don't actually leave, because I have to take 40 years before.
Okay.
No, I mean, you can like,
he just ran
out of there, but that's what Ian Connor did. That's why I didn't get a 40 Ian Connor against the walls, because he just dipped out to the Uber before we were even there.
Did you sketch him out? You tell me
that
she got or what?
He's Ian Connor.
Who is he? Who is that?
I don't think I sketched him out because he just wanted to get out of there before I could take the picture of him. Are we done?
Yeah, we're done.
Shout out to
the guys. We're done here.
What a great musician.
UG.
Shout out to the young guys for coming through. Appreciate it. Thank you for being there.
Stay positive, love one another.
Shout out to you too, my friends. Thank you. Thank you.
That was fire.
Hey. Man, that was fun. Probably one of the weirdest ones we've ever done.
I like it.
What are y'all doing? You want to show you?
I'm good.
What are you doing? I don't go to church.